Hey, so this is just a little demo video on how to access the portfolio portion of Class Dojo. So there's been a little bit of an update to the accounts and like how they're connected. So I'll give a little information about how to access it. So in order to access your child's portfolio or to upload things from home while we're doing e-learning, you're going to go to classdojo.com like you normally do, or go to the app. If you're signed in as with your account as the parent account, you will need to log out. You can go to the top corner of your screen in order to do that. Just click log out and then it'll bring you back to the screen here. And to log in, you'll click on this corner over here where it says log in, like you normally would. And it's going to prompt you to say log into Class Dojo, and you're going to log in as a student for this feature. So it's going to give you a couple of different ways how to log in. One of the ways, and probably the easiest way, is to scan the QR code, entering the class text code. We won't worry about that just because that is more for our classroom devices, which we're not technically on right now with our e-learning for the most part. And then sign in with Google. We're also not going to worry about that because we're not using Google Classroom on a regular basis in our grade level. So the best way is to scan the QR code. So it's going to look like this. So whether you got that in the picture in the message, or the instructions went to your phone or your email, you can scan that QR code. An easy way to access this is to print it out, so that way it's easy to get to. You can post it anywhere, tape it up on the wall, and your child would be able to use any type of mobile device to scan in and get there. You don't have to worry about passwords, and it's also very private, that so no other student in your child's class can see their work. And vice versa, no other parents can see their work as well. So when you click scan the QR code, it'll come up with a device. It'll access the camera that you have open, and you can hold up that piece of paper to scan it in. Depending on if you're on a desktop or mobile device, or if you have another device that you have the QR code on, you can hold it up to the device you're using. But yeah, another easy way just to be able to access this quickly is to print out that code that you've been given. Also, with the email instructions, you can also use the link in the box that's posted below on those other instructions. The QR code is the same one as the printable that you were you have. The link is also another easy way to access that, but if you want your child to be able to upload their work on their own independently, they can, if you print out that QR code, that's an easy way to be able to do that. So once you scan that QR code, it's going to bring you to your child's student account. There's privacy settings on this, so that way the only one that can see your child's work is your teacher, and then anybody that's connected to your account, whether it's a spouse or grandparents or any other adults in your child's life, they can see that with that agreement with that, but only your child's teachers and then any adults that are connected to your child's account can see their work. So once you're on your child's account, it's going to pretty much be on the home page. So it'll show any stories that I have posted or Ms. Harriman has posted, and just anything like that. And then you're going to want to go over to the portfolio tab. So this is a little bit different from how it was before. So you'll just click on that portfolio tab. And then to add any work samples, you will click the that plus button right there. And it'll ask you, what do you want to create? And if you want to take a picture of the work from your device right at that time, you can click on that feature there. It'll prompt you to take the picture of the work or anything that you want to share there. And you can put that there. If you want to share a video of maybe your child reading aloud or anything like that, you'll click on the video, and then you can click that button right there to start recording, and you can share the work like that. Another way that you can share work is with the drawing tool. For the most part, I won't have you do that as much, but this is a feature that you can use if you don't want to use paper. If your child's on a mobile device, if they want to write their sight words on the drawing tool, like they can write like practice writing that, like go, any rhyming words like that. If they want to draw a picture to share, they can use this tool as well. Depending on what you want to use, that's perfectly fine. So then it'll post to that, and you can click hand in when you're ready to turn in those, turn in that. That just is a way to save paper and to be able to do that digitally if you prefer that. So I'll click close on that since we won't be turning that in. So click don't save for that. Another way that you can submit work is by uploading a file. Say you already recorded something on your cell phone or already took a picture on your cell phone or other mobile device and you wanted to share that, you'll just click on file and you can upload the image, and that'll prompt you, it'll take you to your gallery on your mobile device or just like the documents if you're on a computer or different things, and you can upload it from there. So you can select either, if it's a picture, just click on the image, if it's a Word document, which we probably won't be using so much, or a video, you'll click on the file right there. So that's another way that you can share work. And then there's also another feature where you can do journal. This is better to use on a desktop at this point, but if you do want to use a mobile device, it'll bring up your mobile device's keyboard, and you can have your child type in a response. That's one way you can submit work. We really won't be using the journal feature as much compared to the photo, video, and the file options. So those three options will be the best ways to submit work. If your child wants to draw a picture and share it with me, I love that as well. You can do that. The journal feature we won't use as much since we don't have a primary focus on keyboarding and kindergarten, but your child's welcome to use that if they want to practice just for fun. So that is how you can submit work doing through the portfolio. You will have to access or do that through the student account in order to submit the work. And then once the work is submitted, it'll go to my account and I'll put it on for approval, and then you'll get a notification on your parent account that will allow you to be able to see the work and the feedback on that as well. So after I've approved the upload, you'll be able to see it on the parent account. You won't be able to submit from the parent account, but you can submit from the student account. So I hope this was helpful. Let me know if you have any other questions about accessing the portfolio section of Class Dojo. So I hope this is a helpful tool for you guys. And yeah, thank you for watching.